Mac has played a huge part in my training camp. The protein, the ZMA, everything, the pre-workout, it's played such a major part in my training camp, keeping me healthy, keeping me recovered, keeping me feeling good, strong, and ready for my next workout.
Hey everybody, Marcos Villegas here in Las Vegas, being joined with Bob Arum. And Bob, we're set this Saturday. Tyson Fury returning to Las Vegas against Otto Wallin. A lot of people wanting to know, how did we get to Otto Wallin?
Well, we wanted a big guy. We threw our lines out to every heavyweight. Povetkin was one who turned it down. We thought that Wallin was the best guy available. I mean, he's undefeated, hits pretty well. He'll give Fury a good fight. But, you know, as far as I'm concerned, there's not a heavyweight out there who's going to beat Fury.
Is he going to be another Tom Schwartz? He's not at that level, right? He's better than Tom Schwartz, because I know Tyson dispatched of Schwartz in two rounds, and a lot of people are hoping that this guy will give Fury a bigger challenge than Schwartz.
Well, you know, Schwartz wasn't a bad fighter. Fury made him look silly because Fury is just so good. But I think Wallin is coming in looking to win the fight, and I think he's going to give Fury a good fight. But there ain't nobody that's going to beat Fury, I'm telling you that. I mean, he's going to take Wilder out in five or six rounds.
Five, six rounds this time. What makes you think that?
Because I know where he was when he fought Wilder the first time, and I know where he is now and the confidence he had, and he's a big puncher and he's a tremendous boxer, and there's no fighter around that's remotely like him. I mean, you imagine Andy Ruiz fighting him? I mean, it'd be a joke.
Fighting who?
Fighting Tyson Fury.
A lot of people would say that that's a good matchup because of Andy's speed and what he did with Joshua. You just told me your side. Why do you feel that it would be a joke of a fight?
Because Andy has to be on stilts to hit this guy. I mean, you know, try punching up 7 inches, 8 inches. It's very, very difficult to fight a guy who moves like Fury does and punches as well as he does.
Now he is a guy that every time I see him fight, I am surprised by the way he's able to move. On that point, people would say, well, Joshua is a big guy too, and Andy was able to catch him and knock him down 4 times.
Joshua can't move. You know, Joshua can't take it to the body. So if Andy Ruiz was the worst opponent for Joshua, because he takes a good shot, does Andy. He has very fast hands, and he murdered Joshua to the body. I mean, he was the wrong opponent, and he's going to do it again.
You think he's going to win more decisively?
I don't know about more decisively. He's going to win. He's going to knock Joshua out again.
Knockout. As bad as the first time?
I don't know as bad. I mean, how would I know bad, good? But he's going to win, and he's going to win by knockout.
Now, Andy went on his Instagram Live yesterday. I don't know if you heard, and he brought up the card in Tyson Fury, saying that he's Mexican and all that, and he pretty much said, Tyson, stay in your lane, like, rep your own country.
I you can say that. That's sort of funny. But Tyson Fury coming in on this Mexican Independence weekend, waving a Mexican flag, is not something that he's out of his lane. He's showing great respect for the Mexican fans and the contribution that Mexicans, including Andy Ruiz, have made to this sport.
The February fight, that's already signed, right? That is going to happen.
That is correct.
So Fury obviously has to win, but it's all dependent on what happens with Wilder and Ortiz, right?
Well, he sure has to win, yeah. But I look for Wilder to take care of business with Ortiz. Am I thrilled that the fight's happening? No, but it was already signed, and they couldn't get out of it.
So how is it going to work? Because Tyson's with Top Rank ESPN, Wilder's with PBC, Showtime, Fox. How are we going to...
Well, delete Showtime from the... Tyson is with ESPN, and Wilder is with Fox. Fox and ESPN, like all networks, major networks, have a tradition of working together now. Fox and ESPN work together very, very well. CBS works together. NBC works together. ABC works together. You will see, like in football, American football, where Sunday afternoon, when CBS and Fox are doing games, they all say, don't forget to watch tonight's game, which is on NBC. Don't forget to watch Monday night's game, which is on ESPN. The idea that these networks are going to fight like children is only true with the two premium networks that fought like idiots. Instead of building a sport, fought against each other. But the over-the-air networks, ESPN, have a whole tradition of working together.
Obviously, you're referencing HBO and Showtime and how difficult it was to make the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight. Why is it that, in your opinion, they're that way as opposed to what you're explaining to me right now?
Because the people they had running those sports departments were infants, immature, and couldn't get hired by a major network. Major networks understand how to work together, and they should work together. This is not a zero-sum game, which HBO and Showtime made it, a zero-sum game. You lose, we win. Well, the networks know better than that.